to settle on the mat. If you need to open the legs, move the legs just to feel comfortable in, on the knee, that's okay. Yes, so don't force. Whenever you feel knee pain, stretch your legs and come back. Little by little, you will get used to the position. Yeah? So start to settle, start to bring your awareness to your breathing. If it's possible, we breathe in and breathe out through your nose. At least the breathe in, yeah? So when we breathe in through the nose, we activate the filter of the nostrils and we activate the center of energy that we have on the nostrils as well. So imagine that the nostrils, nice and active, is helping more to filter the energy that you breathe. Really important in these times that we are living. Yeah? So imagine that you breathe in and you, your own body is filtering that energy, and also breathe in today this beautiful sunlight that we have today, and imagine receiving this sunlight and imagine this energy moving through your body, through your mind, through your heart, starting to melt away the tension, the tiredness, stress, worries. And on the breathe out, imagine that you start to release down, to let go all of that tension that this energy is dissolving. And then imagine expanding your roots into the floor or reconnecting with the roots that are already there waiting for you. Imagine that you are plugging yourself into those roots. And the roots are taking all that tension, that stress, and is recycling that energy so you can breathe it back nice and pure again, ready to be used again. And plus you receiving the energy from the planet. Yeah? So imagine the roots expanding inside the planet, looking for the kind of energy that you need in this moment. Yeah? You don't have to worry about it. Imagine your roots know everything that you need and they are absorbing for you all that energy. So with all that images in mind, we relax the hands or on the legs or on the floor. And we soften, we let go. Surrender without forcing, okay? So it doesn't matter how much we are right to the floor. Just let go. Relax your neck, relax your head. And imagine your hands also connecting with those roots to let go the more closer tension, for example, on the shoulders, on the neck. And then we move the hands to one side. No forcing it. Using the breathe out to surrender, to let go. And then to the other side. And then to the center, coming back. We put the hands behind, grounding your hips. Open your belly, your chest. Relax your shoulders away. Open your neck without forcing it too much back. And imagine that you are breathing also like through your chest and your solar plexus. Yeah? Like the body, when it's opening, you are receiving energy. And then relax your chin to the chest. And soften. Now we bring the other leg forward. Again, if at any point you need to open the legs, open. Ground your hips. Again, put your hands on the legs or on the floor. And we soften wherever is possible. Yeah? So relax. Let go. Relax your head, your neck, Imagine your hands touching the roots and letting go all the tension that you carry or absorbing the energy that you need. And then slowly we go to one side. And then to the other side. And then to the center, coming back. We put the hands behind, grounding your hips, open your chest, shoulders away, breathing deeply. And then relax your chin to the chest. And then we soften. And we will move the chest in circles. So use like the weight of your body to soften and to ground more your hips, to open your inner thighs, but without forcing. And imagine that you are receiving a beautiful, soothing, relaxing, gentle energy into yourself as you move. You can keep imagining the sunlight coming your way to melt and dissolve everything that you need to let go, physically or emotionally. And then we go to the other side. And then on the center, lengthen the spine, shoulders away. And we go slowly to rotate, keeping the spine straight, the back of the neck long. With your belly a little bit in, we rotate bit by bit without forcing the shoulders away from your ears. Now we will bring the shoulder that is back toward the knee. Yeah? So nice and keeping the hand. Yeah? So you relax the shoulder toward the knee, wherever is possible. And we move the head to the other shoulder. And then you press again into the hips to come back to the twist. Nice and soft, but nice and open. Yeah? And then on your next breathe out, again, we relax the shoulder toward the knee. We rotate the head to the other side. And in your next breathing, pushing into the hips to open into the twist. So do it one or two more times in your own rhythm. Relaxing when you go forward, softening the neck. And back. And we do the last one. Back. And then come back to the center. So again, grounding into the hips, lengthen the spine, relax your shoulders, belly a little bit in, and we start to rotate the spine. Yeah, so the hips stay. Rotate only the spine bit by bit, lengthening the back of the neck, shoulders away. And then we soften the shoulder. We move the head to the other side. And again, pressing into the hips, open your chest. Expand and relax in your own rhythm, really gentle, so you can feel your body in both positions. go. Pardon. And then coming back to the center. And we relax, yeah? So we'll put the hands and the knees on the floor. Anything that you need, Rachel, in particular? Hips. Perfect, good. So we go to all fours. Shoulders away, and we move the hips in circles. So if it's possible, when you go forward, breathe in. When you go back, breathe out. And then the opposite direction. Good, and then on the center. So, breathing open, arching, shoulders away, expanding. And breathe out and rounding. And again, so when you breathe in, when you arch, let your belly, your lower back soft, lifting the head up. And when you round, really bring your belly, the lower belly in and round as much as you can, relaxing your neck and your head. And then we curl the toes, we put the back of the toes on the floor, expanding, and then squeezing. Breathing, arching, expanding, and squeeze. And one more time. Squeeze. And then we open the knees and we go to child pose. So go as much back as you can, again without forcing. If we can't arrive to with the head on the floor, we put the hands beneath your forehead to make it more comfortable. And try to relax your shoulders and your elbows. Surrender to the floor. Imagine the roots here extracting from your body all the tension, stiffness, tightness, any discomfort. And then we move the hands to one side. And then to the other side. And then coming back to the center. We go to all fours. And with the shoulders relaxed, we bring the arm beneath. We put the shoulder, we put the head, and really soft the front arm on the floor, relaxing. Letting go the shoulder blade and the elbow. Letting go, yeah, so relax your chest into the arm that is beneath. And then we change, we put the other arm, soften. And then coming back, we go 12 force again. And we will roll upper back in circles. The idea is that you round your upper back, expanding your shoulder blades, and then you let the shoulder blade fall and the chest. Yeah? And then the opposite direction. Good. And relax. Well done. So we will put the hands, we will go again like a child pose, and we will put the hands with your fingertips. Yeah. So before you go, just for what we were trying to work the last week, for the shoulder blades, for the position on the downward facing dog. So check that your shoulders are relaxed. Yeah? And then you go back with your bum, relaxing your belly, relaxing your chest. But check that the shoulders are not or lifted. Yeah? Soften like with your chest and your solar plexus. Back. Not forcing, try to soften and rotate the shoulders away. Okay? Yeah, so check that the shoulders are not tense. Okay? Oh, and soften, relax. Yeah? So check this softness here. Yeah? Checking that you can move the shoulder blades and the chest. Yeah? Do it. We'll do this a little bit, just 2 seconds. Yeah? So put the hands here, yeah? And try to bring the shoulder blades together and then spreading. Yeah? So bring the shoulder blades like closer to each other and then separate. Yeah? One more time. And then separate. Yeah? So when we do the downward facing dog, try to keep that separation of the shoulder blades and the softening of the chest, yeah? Not lifting the shoulder blades, yeah? So down, separated, and then soften. We will try it in the downward facing dog, yeah? Slowly, yeah, he said. So I'm talking also as well with Mary on the table. So shoulders away, yeah? So again, when you bend the legs here, try to spread the shoulder blades, the shoulders away from your ears, and then you move with your hips and with your solar plexus and relaxing your head and your neck, yeah? Softening. And move a little bit side to side so you can move your upper body without feeling that you are tensing it to go into the... beautiful, very nice, very nice. Oh, well done. Now we work on the legs now, yeah? So moving, yeah. And we try with both legs. Don't worry if you can extend it. Go with the hips, belly, solar plexus, shoulder blades and chest, and head and hips. Very nice, very nice. We put the knees on the floor, and we will go with one leg, shoulders away, expanding, arching, and then rounding, squeezing the lower belly. Breathing, open, arching. And rounding. And one more time. And then when we go forward, we will try to cross the leg over. Yeah? So putting the knee in and then we soften. Yeah? So crossing over the other leg and soften. Just to stretch that part of the thigh. Yeah? So rounding and crossing. And last one, rounding and back. Yeah, cool. We go with the other leg. So breathing open, expanding. And forward, belly in, relaxing your head. Expanding open, shoulders away, and rounding. And one more time. Good. And then we cross. This is good for the thigh, for the side of the thigh, and for the lower back. Soft. Yeah. One more time. Crossing. Well done. Very nice. And then we will bring one leg forward. And we will go to a standing position. Grounding your feet. Open the sole of your feet, open the toes, checking that you don't extend the knees completely, and pressing, and we expand without tensing your shoulders, yeah? So soft and lengthen, expand. Imagine as you move and as you press into the floor, you are receiving the energy from the roots, yeah? From the planet, plus you are absorbing the energy and the sunlight. We will go to the side, soften without tensing, expanding without tensing. And then we go to the other side. And then one more time, expanding. Relax, good. And we soften a little bit the shoulders, yeah? Back and down, yeah? Back and down, keeping the knees soft. So we'll go to the top of the mat. And again, expanding really nice your feet, your toes, breathing open. Imagine absorbing the energy from beneath and the energy from above. We soften, hips out, belly, solar plexus, chest, head. Relax. Soften. Stay a little bit there. Keeping the knees bent. Your upper back is soft. Wherever you can go, doesn't matter how much you go to the floor, yeah? It's keeping the knees bending and wherever you can go. Relax your neck. Soften completely your neck. Yeah, well done. Good. Now we put the hands on your shins or on your knees. We look up, keeping the bum out, shoulders again away from your ears. Try to expand your spine, your chest, yeah, without tensing it. Yeah? And then we will put the hands on the floor. We will go back to plank. Shoulders away. So try to keep the spine straight. The hips are tilting forward. Shoulders away from your ears. Knees on the floor. So we can do all fours, or we try to go lower with your chest between the hands, elbows closer to each other, and then belly in, expanding. Open, shoulders back without arching. And then we go hips, belly, solar plexus, chest, head, and heels. Good, expanding open. We bring the right leg forward, we go to warrior two. So we can go directly with your feet or we can put the knees on the floor and then your foot, yeah? Grounding, set, yeah, so. Relax, yeah, check the front knee, okay? Yeah, so that the arch is active, just the action of lifting the arch, your knee will go into place, yeah? That's good to keep. And also that could be what creates the pain, yeah? Okay, cool. So bending the leg, yeah? Yeah, keep, relax your hips down, yeah? Yeah, and keep it a little bit more, the knee a little bit. So keep the foot, yeah? And try to breathe, that action, yeah? Okay, settle. And we put the arm onto the front leg. Grounding hip, open chest, shoulders away, lifting your arm. Very nice, soft. We can bring the arm more forward. Try to feel that you create a line between your heel and your fingers, lengthening the side of your body without forcing it, beautiful. And then back, put the hand on the back leg, open the front, and keep the knees as well, yeah? Very nice, yes. That tiny action, that could bring the, and soften, both. And coming back to plank. Shoulders away, yeah? Cool. And chest and chin, or all fours. Shoulders away. Even if you relax your groins here, don't go all the way because that forces your lower back and your shoulders, yeah? So you are stay on your arms. Then we go up, hips, belly, solar plexus, chest, and head. And we bring the left leg forward. Again, we can put the knees first, yeah? Good. So checking again the arch of your foot, yeah? And comfy. And settle. Good, relax, yeah? Soften, 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 yeah. Good. We put the arm on the front leg and open. So you can use even the arm to help you to keep the knee in place. And we open the rest. Open. Shoulder away, settle. Relax, very nice. Bring them forward and try to feel that stretch from the heel to the fingers, but checking that you are not tensing it. Yeah? The breathing, remember the breathing is make you realize if you are tensing or you are in a good place. Yeah? Pressing into the front leg, we open. Relax your hips, shoulders away, coming back, and we rotate. And back to plank, lengthen, yes, shoulders away. Yeah? And then chest and chin, belly in, expanding and opening. We go up, hips, belly, solar plexus, chest, head and heel. We bring the legs forward toward the hands. And we go all the way up, expanding and lengthening. Yeah? Remember that if we can't go directly with the feet, we can go first with the knees and then your foot. Yeah? So we do one more time. Expanding. Yeah, imagine receiving. And then when you breathe out, imagine you are letting go the tension. Softening. Breathing lengthen open. Breathe out plank. Shoulders away. And we go. One more time. Chest and chin. Slowly, belly. Expanding. Go and back. Open. We bring the right leg forward. We go to warrior one now. So we face the front. We rotate belly strong here. Check that we are not touching on the lower back. So we settle again. Again, the knee. Check that it's in place. Open and expand. Shoulders away. So working on lengthening and coming to the center to strengthen this area, shoulders away, the back of your foot comfortable. Yeah, shoulders, expand, very nice. Now we will put the hands behind, soften shoulders back, so check that rotation, check that the shoulder is not forward. Yeah? We will go hip, so foot, hip, and then belly, solar plexus, chest and head, and then we go head, chest, belly in, And we lift in the arms, shoulders away, lengthening up. Don't go too much back, yeah? Even if you can. Expand one more time. Rotate the shoulders. And we go hips, belly, solar plexus, chest, head, and then again head, chest, belly, expand, open, rotate, back to plank, and we soften, yeah? So chest and chin, or all fours, belly, expand, we go up, open, we bring the left leg forward, grounding, connecting, yeah? So rotate, and we move, expanding. So rotate to face the front. With the back foot, move it as you need, yeah? Go. We put the hands behind. Rotate the shoulders, open. And we go, foot, hip, belly, solar plexus, head. And then head, open, expand. Belly strong, we lift. Shoulders away, connecting, yeah? Chuck. And then relax, one more time. Rotate the shoulders, and we go. Expanding, open, relax. And open back, expanding, go. Ah, release. We go back to plank. And we go forward, chest and chin. Slowly, belly in, expanding. We go up, open. And then relax. Good. Now we will go to, we stay in the downward facing dog. And we will bring the right leg up. And back. Yeah? Good. So imagine that foot wants to go far away from your hands, but your belly and your chest is still softening toward the leg that is on the floor. Yes, yeah? So you open the upper back, relaxing your head. Good. And then we will bring that knee forward toward the wrist. Yeah? So you bring the knee out, and then you move the leg back. Cool, very nice. So trying to keep the center, yeah? Relax your shoulders, don't force the lower back. And imagine that you want to go first with the groin, belly, solar plexus, far away, yeah? And then try to soften your shoulders and relax, yeah? This is another good position for that pain, yeah? Soften. Don't worry if you can go lower, go wherever is possible for you. Check the shoulders as well, yeah? Go, soften. Yeah. So check, yeah? Normally I will go with the hand. So check if you can move this hand a little bit, the left hand, a little bit more on the side. Ah. To soften. Check if it feels okay. Yeah, if not, come back to the normal position. Yeah. And try to soften using your breathing to relax toward the floor, wherever is possible. We keep the lower back centered. So as you relax, check the different areas of your body where you hold tension. And try to soften it. And then coming back, we keep the position, yeah? We put the hands, shoulders again away from your ears, opening your chest, lengthen the back of the neck. So you ground without forcing back. Yeah? It's more the solar plexus, the chest and head, the back of the neck. Yeah? Spread, breathe, yeah? Relax shoulders. And then slowly we go up to downward facing dog. Yeah? Good. Softening. Yeah? So feel for a moment the difference between that leg and the other leg. Yeah? You feel it longer or higher the hip. Yeah, that's the stretch that we gain. Now we will go with the left leg back and up. Again, opening. Like a downward facing dog. Yeah, your upper body is open, it is expanding, it's lengthening. Trying to soften at the same time your upper body. Yeah. And then we bring that knee forward, out. Yeah. Toward the side, but your body stays on the center. So take a moment, spread without forcing. And imagine that you start with the groin, belly, solar plexus, chest, and then wherever you can put your hands. And we soften, relax, shoulders away. So again, once you are settled on the hips, check your shoulders, yeah? Soften. Relax, yeah, using the breathe out to soften. Oh. If we need, we can put the hands beneath your forehead. Yeah, so check whatever makes you feel more comfortable on the whole body as well. Yeah. The elbows, the shoulders, the chest. Surrendering. And then coming back. Put the hands without forcing on the lower back. Yes, so expanding like from the groin again. Belly, solar plexus, chest, back of the head. Back of the neck, shoulders are back, softening. And then we come back to downward facing dog. Expanding and opening. Softening, relax. Good. And we will go again to child pose. To soften the hips, the hands could be or on the front or beneath your forehead or beside your body. Good, relaxing. Letting go. Yeah. Good. And then slowly we will go to hero pose. Yeah? So we can do this pose in this position or sitting. Yeah, if this is not comfortable, we sitting normally on the floor or even on a chair, maybe, okay? So we sit either with the hips grounding into the floor or into the heels. Yeah, you can put blankets beneath your legs or between your feet and your bum. Expanding, so pressing into the hips to lifting the spine and have the solar plexus nice and open. Shoulders are relaxed. Let go. We open the arms. Check that your shoulders are away. Expanding, yeah, imagine that you're receiving this beautiful sunlight. And then we will round the back. Imagine that you are collecting all that energy. You bring it closer to yourself, to your body, and we will cross the arms, catching the shoulder blades. Yeah? So, wherever is possible, with the shoulders away from your ears, and breathe in, expanding. Breathe out, we round back. Yeah, so in your own time, imagine that you are pumping that energy into yourself, into your body with the movement. So in the breathing, you keep receiving always energy, and then you bring the energy in. One more time. Good. Well done. And then we open again. Again, imagine that we are receiving again. Shoulders away. And then we will bring the other arm on the top, rounding. Imagine that you bring the energy into yourself. You put it in with this closing, with this hug. And breathing open. And breathe out, relaxing. And as you do this pose, imagine also that you are giving yourself a big hug, a loving hug. Good. And one more time. Good. And relax, release. Well done. We will put one arm up and one down, softening again the shoulder, checking that we are not tensing. We will put one hand behind or over the head, wherever is possible. The other hand behind, but rotating the shoulder away again. And we open and we expand without forcing it. So the feeling of tension or strength is coming from that grounding of the hips to the solar plexus, but the upper body is trying to be relaxed so you can release the tension that we carry here. Using your breathing. And then soften, shoulders away. And we put the arm behind with a rotation. The other hand, wherever is possible. And again, expanding without tensing. Breathe. And then relax, soften. Good. So we'll stretch the legs back. Good. Well done. And we will sit in for a moment. Cool. Well done. Very nice. Good. Yeah, no, take it, take it. So we will start with one leg bend, we will do another stretch for the time. Yeah? So comfy on this leg, we put the other leg crossing over or wherever your foot allows you. Yeah. So wherever is comfortable, you put your foot and then try to settle on the center. Now, don't worry if you can't put both hips. You try. Center in your body. Okay? So we catch the thigh. We try to bring the thigh towards you to feel this nice stretch. Lifting your spine, again, shoulders away. And we will do a little twist here. Catching the leg. Expanding, and we rotate nice and soft, but bringing the leg towards you. Yeah, cool. Now keep opening the solar plexus, Mara. Yeah. Whoop. Shoulders away. It's also because when we have sunshine, if we can work on the solar plexus, it's good because it's like we store the sunlight there. And soften, well done. And we will change, yeah? We go with the other leg. Again, you check wherever is possible, even on the front, yeah? So check wherever is okay. And again, catch the leg first and ground again with your hips to feel that expansion. And then bring the leg wherever is possible. So do a little bit of bringing, but not tensing the shoulders, yeah? Cool. And then we rotate, keeping this expansion here. And keep the chest and the solar plexus open, shoulders away. And then relax, release well. We stretch the legs and we will go to lying down on your back. So comfy, bending the legs, softening your back, shoulders away. Good, comfy. So take a moment to feel from the hips, then the lower back, middle back, upper back. Even you can always bring your head a little bit separated from the floor to try to bring the chin toward the chest and then spread back into the floor, feeling that you extended your back even more and then your shoulder blades, yeah, softening. Relax and then with your hips a little bit tilting forward to feel even more deeply your lower back, we will start to go to bridge, starting from your feet. So you press into the feet, imagine that you're lifting your thighs and your groins using the strength of your feet. The belly in, go into the back of the neck as much as you can and into the top of your shoulders there. So you keep pressing into the feet, expanding, yeah? Go. And then relax, release, we soften. Relax, yeah? Oh. Now we will put the hands beside your body, more or less, yeah? Doesn't need to be perfect there. Check that you can rotate the shoulders away from your ears. The hands like directing forward toward your feet. Yeah. And then again, you press into the feet, going up slowly with your thighs, with your groins, going even more deeply into the back of the neck, into the top of your shoulders. And here you can bring the shoulder blades more closer to each other and expand the back of the neck. Pressing into your feet. And then relax, release, and we soften. Good. Now bring your knees toward your chest, toward your belly, and soften. Relax. Well done. Now what we will do, we will try to cross the leg here, like a between your knees, yeah, yes, and soften the legs, yeah, cool. So like you stay, yeah, imagine this action that we do with the arms, yes, exactly, that's also for this part, yeah, and relax your feet, yeah, and then just move there a little bit side to side. So this is a nice action when we do a pigeon pose, that is the opposite opening, just to work both sides of the hips, yeah? And you can increase, if you like, without forcing it, catching the knees with opposite, yes. And bringing the legs closer to you, to your belly, not in a forcing way, so you will feel the stretch on your glutes, on your hips, and the side, yeah? So it's not a forcing action, eh? It's a, with the comfortable feeling that you get when you bring the knees to the chest, yeah? Good. And then we change. We try to do it on the other side. Remember, we always have one way that is more comfortable than the other, yeah? And again, trying to soften there. Soften your feet, yeah? Good. And soften. Relax. Good. And then we separate the legs. Keep the thighs comfy, like outside the body. We can catch the thighs or the calf or your feet in happy baby pose. Yeah? Check if you can keep the shoulders away from your ears and the shoulder blades on the floor. The head on the floor so you can relax your whole back. If your feet are not comfortable, then you put your hands on your thighs or on your calf. Yeah? So no need to force. Go. And then we relax. And we will go to a spinal twist, bringing the knees toward one side. Softening, relaxing your shoulder blades, letting go completely. Imagine that you are breathing, bringing back the images of the roots beneath you and the energy around you, that you are being filled with the beautiful light of the sun and all the energy that you are receiving from the planet. All these energies are moving through your body, through yourself, purifying and refreshing and recharging your body, your mind, your heart. And then to the other side. And then coming back to the center, and we go to Shavasana. Yeah, so we comfortable, we spread your body there, yeah, nice and comfy. Put your blanket if you need, or your clothes. Good. Very nice. Good. So once you are nice and comfortable, again, visualize the roots beneath you, offering you a beautiful place to relax, to let go, to rest. And imagine that those roots are bringing you now a beautiful energy of relaxation and peace, plus all the nourishment that you need. And all around you, now you have a loving, caring energy surrounding you, minding you, and you're absorbing that loving energy into yourself with each breath. So imagine all those energies combined now will form another beam of energy that will enter into your body through your feet. And imagine this energy moving right now on the sole of your feet, on your toes, the top of your feet, your ankles, your lower legs, your knees and your thighs, your hips, your lower back, middle back, upper back, shoulder blades. Imagine that energy moving through your arms, toward your hands, your fingers. And then imagine that energy moving through your wrists, elbows, shoulders, the back of your neck, the back of your head, the crown of your head, your face, your neck, your chest, your belly. Allowing your body to surrender completely to the floor and going deeply inside now. and relax, relax, relax. And now slowly, really slowly, allow your awareness to get back to your body and start to bring some movements to your hands, to your feet, moving your fingers, your toes, moving your head side to side, and bringing your arms back. And lengthen and stretch. And from there we fall to one side, bending your knees. And we go to a sitting position, crossing your legs. And breathing deeply. Now give a big thanks to yourself for taking the time to come to class. And I thank you for sharing your time and your practice with me. Thank you.